Goosebumps.
Emporia, Kansas is on the flyway of the majestic Canada goose. The cowboys working at the feedlot saw a lot of these big birds. They like corn and silage, as well as the steers like it. Jim is a journeyman feedlot cowboy and was demonstrating his ability with his rope as they pushed some poles up the alley to the vet shack. The other cowboys respected him and knew that his team rope and buckle was real. Whilst displaying the proper angle and how to control the tip, he lost control. The rope slipped from his hands and shot straight up in the air. Coincidentally, the lead gander of a low-flying squadron of geese heading in for a lunch break flew right into Jim's loop. Honest. I mean, there were witnesses. The goose slapped to the ground like a wayward tether ball. He rose in a squawk and a flurry of feathers, sighted in on Jim, and charged. Jim was riding Buck. Buck was only three. And though he had adjusted to the roar of the feed mill, the klaxon of the bucket loader in reverse, and the smell of Overflow Lagoon, he had never been attacked by maddened waterfowl. Buck swapped ends as Jim grabbed a horn and achieved 0-60 in less time than it takes to spell Pyrocantharynchus hyrudinaceus. At the end of the alley, approaching at the speed of a Tiger Woods tee-off, was a concrete feed bunk. While Jim was debating whether to punch the ejection seat, Buck took to the air and sailed over the concrete obstacle. To no one's surprise, the pursuing goose lifted off the runway and soared between the lip of the bunk and the horizontal neck cable. Unfortunately, he was dragging 35 foot of 3/8 soft lay right-hand twist nylon rope. The trailing tail of the rope whipped around the cable. The elasticity of the steel, the nylon, and the vertebrae allowed the feathered projectile to stretch far enough to spring the goose back across the feed bunk like Venus Williams returning a serve. He managed to bounce in a muddy spot and survive. The audience of cowboys hooted, honked, and hollered over the feat of Jim's heading a goose. Jim regained his composure, eased the snorting buck over to the bunk, and announced that tomorrow he would demonstrate his technique, goose healing.